Who's fresh off the mats as the root tester, looking slightly stressed, and Sean McCall. Gaz, over to you.
Well, welcome back, everybody. It's been a great event already. Olga, you've literally just walked through the door and sat on the sofa, and you've been working hard out there by the looks of it.
Yeah, that's right. We tried to do our best after not super perfect female rounds, especially. We tried to prepare better finals. We tweaked a lot, we tried a lot, and we'll see what will happen, actually. It's always hard to find the proper level, to don't make it too hard or too easy, and also it depends which boulder is first, second, and third, so it's always a surprise also for us.
I think many times there's usually a last-minute tweak, a last-minute little adjustment of something very small sometimes, or something a bit big, and I mean, it really does come down to everybody's experience in the team, and you work together as a route setting team, I understand.
Yeah, exactly. But sometimes it's necessary also to try just before the finals to have a kind of view what we set actually already 6 days ago, mm-hmm. and what we have now, and how the athletes perform in the semis. So there is a lot of things about which we have to think.
There was a couple of interesting results where early climbers in the semi-final did actually do very well on those boulders and vice versa, the other way around.
So, that's right.
Yeah, it was quite interesting semi-final. But I think there's always some surprises.
Yeah, but it's happened quite often, because sometimes those who are starting as a first have a less pressure and maybe more a fresh mind. At least that's how I see it.
Yeah, very common. Oh, okay then. Over to Daria. So, from your perspective, you were a competitor in the semi-final.
Yeah.
Did you enjoy it?
Yeah, it was quite fun. Nice. Boulders was really cool, but I wasn't fit enough. So, I like the boulders, but I think it was a bit easier for us, the girls, because it's 9 or 10 girls do all.
Nine. Yeah, agreed. Was slightly too easy.
Yes. So. But I like the boulders. It was quite nice.
I think it's always a very fine line between too easy and too hard.
It's
like
so difficult.
Smallest, most micro adjustments ever,
and
suddenly there's 10 people at the top. The foothold is like half a centimeter bigger, and it's suddenly possible.
It was so scary, really. I was like, oh, no, thank you. I go.
The one with the three triangles, Travis, at the end, and the last hard move, the big move.
Yes, it was so big move, and I was like, oh, I'm not so tall.
That was a little heartbreaker for a lot of people, actually.
Yeah.
Yeah, and Sean, you know, from your perspective, this is not very normal for you being a spectator in the arena. How was it?
It was really interesting, and to Olga's credit, what she said about some of the earlier climbers coming out, they have no pressure. They're technically like last in the round, and so whatever they do, they're just putting pressure on the higher qualified competitors to do well. And obviously with Maddie coming out and flashing all four, like, that was incredible. And then you're like, oh, okay, you're gonna have four. And I'm like, I didn't expect another five competitors to flash all four, but I did expect another five competitors to top all four. Eventually a lot of them got to the top, and so it's hard, but like, we all know that that's where the rules come in. And so with the try is at like, you know, 13 and 15, it is for sure unfortunate they don't make it to the finals, but I'm more heartbroken with seventh place that really had four tops, I think, in seven tries, and it was just the one try to zone, something like that. That's the most heartbreaking, because it's like, oh, if we could just change it a bit. But then also, to the Rootsetter's credit, the men's round was actually really phenomenal with any three tops getting you in. Obviously one competitor got four, one competitor got three, but then if you got two tops, having to get all four zones, we love to see that as a competitor. So they did some things really, really well.
Yeah, and looking back at the men's semifinals, Jakob didn't do boulder number one, and it was the most climbed boulder in the men's semifinal. And this is really interesting. Yeah, he's still performed.
Yeah, because the rest of the boulders. A little bit infamous for doing that, for dropping the slab boulder and being strong enough. So, like, never count Jakob out. Let's just put it that way.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, he's a total legend, and he just continues to try hard all the way through the round, and, you know, he's probably going to be there. But he was climbing in a stiff pair of shoes on that slab, which is... I don't know if he owns a soft pair of shoes. Maybe not. You might know him a little bit better.
Yeah, a hard one. He's a phenomenal climber, and is one of his biggest weaknesses, slab, and he works on it a ton. Like, I actually kind of similar to me. It's not really my specialty, but I can sometimes get through it. And he can sometimes get through the slabs. And in World Cups, when he does the slab, he's so fired up because he knows that he is probably going to be okay on one of the other boulders. But then, yeah, you get it in this situation where he can't do it. And again, he's like, okay, I've been here before. I have to do it. And like, I'm laughing, but like, he's a phenomenal competitor. He would laugh as well, even during their interview. Obviously, he's in the finals, so we get to see how he's going to do in these boulders.
And Daria, are you one of these competitors that will come out with two different types of boots to a boulder? Do you compete in that way? Soft pair, stiff pair? Do you climb with a soft pair of boots and a stiff pair of boots in a competition?
I climb in one pair.
Just one pair?
Just one pair.
And is that a soft pair or a medium?
It just doesn't matter for me.
Okay. Interesting. It's really interesting how some people can be really super obsessed with this. I have to have that perfect pair of boots for this boulder, and I have to take my fingers in this very specific way. And other people are just, I just go climbing, just pull on and
I just
try
like
hard
to climb a slab, so I have for it normal shoes, so it's okay for climbing roof.
You wear a shoe that's all rounder.
It doesn't matter.
Yeah. And Olga, when you're setting boulders, do you take things like that into consideration? Maybe like, oh, I'm going to put on a really bad foothold here. That if you've got a very stiff shoe, it'll be really good. Or maybe if you've got a soft shoe, it'll be really bad. And then the next foothold is the opposite way around.
Well, obviously we think about the size of the holes, and sometimes we try to put when we are tweaking, sometimes we are not making bigger moves, just more comfortable positions or more risky footholds, as you said. But actually, we are not thinking about their shoes. It's their job to find the proper
choose the right position. Bit of kit. Yeah. And so, what's your predictions? What we're gonna see? Who's gonna be standing on that podium this afternoon?
Oh no, we never think about the personalities who will be on the podium. We count for a good show, good performance of the athletes, and I hope they will do their best, and the best will win.
I think everybody here at Studio Bloc does actually want that. I mean, it's all about having a really good result and a really good show, and nobody specifically.
Yeah, you know, Rootsetters doesn't want to talk about predictions or
so professional, actually.
And any predictions from you, Daria?
I don't know.
In the females?
I can't say, actually. It always depends. So we never can say. Sometimes it can be like super prognostic, but sometimes like, okay, I never expected that she can win or he can win or somebody can be in final. So it's sometimes it's so surprising.
And at the end of the day, I guess it always comes down to the boulders.
It's better for everyone because it's part of show.
Right. Well, I think that's the first competitors out on the mat. Well, thanks for your time, ladies and Sean.
It's Thank been. You for inviting.
That's okay. It's been brilliant. Thank you very much.
Thanks a lot.
Have fun on the stream.
Thanks.
So the mats where this final is about to get underway. The athletes are being presented to what is just an incredible crowd here at Studio Bloc. Somebody during the break said this is the biggest crowd that have ever squeezed in front of the mats here at Studio Bloc. The women finalists are being announced to everybody at the moment. Katja Debovec from Slovenia, super experienced, comes out and shown to the crowd first, followed by one of more local climbers, Roxana Vijnand. Alana Yip, one of Sean's compatriots from Canada, had just a crazy good qualifying and was absolutely brilliant during the semi-final. Really short rotation between semi-finals and finals here, just under 2 hours for the athletes to pretty much just chow down some pizza and get straight on the mats and get warmed up ready for the next round. The legend is Chloe Collier, second in the Studio Bloc Masters in 2020, fourth in the European Championships 2022. Such an experienced competitor, Chloe. Sara Šopa out next. Slovenian qualified in the second top spot. Sara, just 17 years old, first at the Youth A World Championships in Dallas 2022. But an amazing semi-final round for Madison Richardson, also from Canada. Two Canadians in the final. I'm sure Sean and his team will be pretty happy about that. Madison actually came out quite early on in the semi-finals. She was out fifth in semis, so fifth last, and then made it all the way through, held her position with those four flashes in the semi-final round. That is what has made the Rootsetters fairly stressed, I would say, going into this final. They've been tweaking the boulders to the absolute last second, just as the curtain dropped, which is not an enviable position. That is a really bad place to be. Fingers crossed for the Rootsetters tonight. The men are going to start. It's going to be Nikolay Ruzev from Bulgaria. Gaz, you know Nikolay quite well. Great to see such a young athlete come through. He was first out in semi-finals, which is crazy to hold that position all the way through and make it to the finals. What a round he's having, just 17 years old as well.
Absolutely. He pulled out a really, really successful performance on the mats there.
Next out, Slovenian Matic Kota. Matic as part of the crazy strong and sort of inevitably in final Slovenian lineup. So yeah, I was having a bit of a laugh with him just before in the restaurant here at the Studio Bloc. Really good fun to have around. Next guy out needs barely any introduction, Jerne Kruda, 32 years old now. Boulder World Cup winner back in 2018, European champion 2020. Even sixth in 2022 at the Euro Champs, all-round rock climber, bit of a legend on the scene. Great to see Jerne making it all the way through. Ido Fadel back out next. His friends have asked if we can call him Zizo.
Ale Zizo.
Ale Zizo from Israel. So Ido Fadel done super good work during the qualifying round and the semi-finals. He was just 19 years old. Fourth in the European Youth Champs out in Graz, Austria 2022. Following him, though, talk about the big names. The most decorated, most gold medal winning athlete of all time, Jakob Schubert from Austria. As Gaz said on the sofa there, made it pretty hard for himself. Had to battle down to get through the semi-final round. And winning the semi-final rounds in the men's competition was Andrzej Perhacz, who's looked dominant all weekend, really. Fantastic in qualifiers and fought the only guy to get four tops in the semi-final round. Fantastic lineup, Gaz. They're going to go into the observation now, this is edge of your seat stuff. And the atmosphere here at Studio Bloc is like one. We've been here, I think this is our third time here, and it's really nervous, a lot of tension and a lot of very knowledgeable crowd members.
Yeah, there was definitely a lot of pressure on the Rootsetters when we visited the mat earlier on. We were making some really last-minute tweaks. Obviously, I think the female climbers performed a lot better than they expected. And, you know, when Olga joined me on the sofa there, she was, you know, visibly well stressed out. You know, she was
Her heart rate was up, and she was, yeah, taking it on the chin. It was it's a hard call to make last minute changes prior to a final like this. And what, when you mentioned before about the strength of the Slovenian crew, I mean, there's one, two, three men, two women, five Slovenian team members in total on that mat. That's a very, very impressive stat.
Yeah, it's impressive, and the whole team set up, the whole team dynamic is so impressive. Plenty of coaches here, everybody's staying in the hotel actually where we are as well, so you get a slight insight into what's going on and what's happening amongst all the different teams. Hopefully during this observation round we're going to give you a bit of graphic. Gaz and ourselves are route setters. There we are. Now, don't look too closely, but I'm driving the iPad, which is going to be interesting. Men's number one then. Really interesting starting position, left hand up on the pocket, maybe a bit of a pop into the start. And then some terrible sloping jibs and rounded volumes before heading back down and right. The zone hold is actually under the roof there in the grey section.
I did have a look at that zone hold, and I was sort of expecting that one to be quite good. And it's absolutely diabolical. It's very, really disappointing.
Yeah, so that's the graphic of men's number one. As we go screen in screen, you can start to see a little bit. Toe hooks around the back of volumes has been a theme all through this weekend here at the Studio Bloc Masters, and that continues with these really tricky looking section out far right, halfway up the wall there. So far, my driving on the iPad, all right, I would say.
It was a good first lesson, that was.
Good on site. We're going to start on the far left-hand side of this wall here. And years gone by, the infamous Studio Bloc left-hand side. A lot of these boulders have started in the far left corner. This one, I'm pleased to see, starts slightly out of the corner, so there's no weirdness in the corner, and it's a sort of swinging leg swing across the groove there initially into those squadra volumes that are facing towards the left. Then you're working your way up the left-hand side into the zone hold, and then it's a sort of a slab-style finish at the top here. Really, really tricky finish, and a bit of a pounce to finish potentially up on the top here.
It'll be quite interesting to see that first move and the speed that's actually required to get them into that corner. And it looks like you're going to land on the foot and then probably put a heel in, something like that, and then lean across to the zone hold.
So as we move on to this next one, a bit of a conversation here around men's number two, because I haven't ever quite seen a start like this, it has to be said. So three stripes of tape on that first volume, you can see the guys just grappling with there. They are allowed to touch the starting hold. So three stripes of tape on the center of the wall there, and then the fourth stripe of tape is really high up in the wall. It's a right-hand side pull. It's miles away. You can see the stripe of green tape there on your screen going all the way up to the starting position. So they almost got to do a move to get into the start. So, really interesting start there. And this is one of the ones in the route setters where there's a lot of looking and a lot of head-scratching going on. This boulder, in theory, is a bit of a walking slab boulder. Walk the way around to the left-hand side and then up the slab to the top. I've got a slight prediction on that boulder. I'm going to leave that for later. Let's move on to women's number two.
Well, actually, just looking at that mic from earlier on, it looks like one of the hardest moves is to get into the start position. And then after that, you actually do have two really positive holds to go left, and then obviously some quite poor holds again to work your way up back up the slab.
Yeah, women's number two is the slab as well, you can see there. These squadron volumes, lots of dual texture volumes used there. So this is a real footwork-dependent boulder. The zone hold is actually the penultimate hold. It's right up against the top hold there. You can see marked with the pink tape. That's the zone hold, which gives you an indicator that this is a kind of a hands-free slab sort of maneuver we're expecting here. Working your way around to the right-hand side before heading straight up the slab. Gives you an idea there of the angle of this wall.
It's great to see the girls working together, looking at this boulder, and also with some smiles popping out as well as they look at this slab. Probably some grins, thinking, "Oh no, this is going to be hard."
You can see there's a black foothold underneath the sort of third squadra volume, which is a blocked little ledge hold. It's quite positive, but it's probably quite blind for the athletes as they try and wiggle their feet through there, and potentially a really hard step through.
Yeah, maybe a hard step through, or maybe even a foot swap on it.
Move on to boulder number three. Just 2 minutes observation per boulder, which always feels quite intense when you're out there on the mats. So this one is a journey, and this one, when I say it, they were cutting it fine, that's a bit of an understatement. Literally, the curtain was falling, the drills were still in the hand of the root setter. So, yeah, a bit of a burl fest, this one, through the roof, an absolute journey, hopefully from the start all the way down and through to the left. Gives you an idea of how steep this boulder is.
Yeah, this was the one that the guys were working really hard on. When we went round on the curtain to look at the boulder problems from the matting. And yeah, they are probably putting the heart on the line with this one. Not sure exactly what is going to happen, but sometimes that's the way it goes in these competitions and with this boulder setting. You really don't know. Sometimes you just have to commit to it.
A quick look at boulder number three here. The women are just observing that one at the moment. Yeah, like Olga Nimitz was saying, there's been a few little tweaks on this tour of four boulders. Rooms number four is into the steep section, into the steep section as well. Real burling underneath the roof.
Yeah, super physical traverse from left to right from the start hold to get out to the zone. And then looks like there's quite a few feet missing for that last move.
Yeah, potentially standing on the top of this dual texture volume right in the middle of the wall
exactly.
Here.
Exactly. Definitely not the sort of place you want your foot to be standing.
That's ice cream levels of smooth.
It's also pretty vertical when you look at it on the left-hand side of the screen at the moment. It's a pretty rough foothold.
Quite a few zone hole placements really high up on the wall here as well, which makes super interesting. So they've got to put a big battle in to find those scoring positions. Actually, the total number of tops is the first marker on the scoreboard, then the total number of zone holds, and it comes down to attempts on each of those after that. Forward to that one.
Yeah, it's great to see everybody working together. I think most of the girls on the mat there are able to speak English, so it's very easy for them to communicate and work these boulders out together as one.
Yeah, hopefully let's move on to boulder number four. Guys are just shuffling their way down to the right hand side now into you can pretty much get an idea straight away there of men's number four that we're just looking at there. We'll load this guy up. So the women have got a bit of a swing and jump on the first boulder, and the men are on the fourth boulder. What do you call this style, Gaz? Paddling, skating, jumping.
All three.
Parkour.
All of the above.
Falling.
Yeah. Basically starting on the left-hand side on the two green stripes for the hands, two green stripes for the feet, and then you've got to travel all the way over far to the right side of the groove. Which should probably be in one motion, one movement, and then you actually do come back left again and up to the finishing hold in the middle of the wall.
Yeah, so we're thinking swing, paddle across, jump again, double dyno essentially. The names of these jumps each year get more and more ridiculous.
Double paddle, triple dyno.
Ah, that's the one I was looking for.
Something like that, yeah.
Obviously, the guys these days are training this style a lot. Yone seems to be indicating that potentially it's like a double palms down or double palms up to stop over the right-hand side there. Had a really long discussion with Jakob Schubert about this style yesterday, which was super interesting. Personally, he prefers the yank and yard style.
Jakob is actually relatively old in the competition arena now. He's also a lead competitor as well, so it's this whole competition style that's evolved in the last few years. It's something that he's had to put quite a lot of effort in order to try and compete on a level playing field with some of the youngsters coming through. And obviously he still is performing extremely well. He's out on that mat as a qualifier into this final at Studio Blockmasters 2023.
Yeah, women's is into this steep shoe. I'll just bring you around the side there to give you an idea of the steepness of this section. It's just we're in the last few seconds of observation here. A bit more conventional climbing, potentially a little bit dynamic into the zone. Then all aboard the struggle bus to finish, I think. Some side pulls, undercut volumes. Really, really tough stuff at the top there. Really looking forward to these. I'm nervous going into this one. Sometimes you think, yeah, I can see how this is going to go down. But in front of this crowd, The organisers here have just put in crazy amount of effort to make this work, and yeah, I don't know, you wouldn't really want to hang your hat on any predictions here whatsoever, to be honest.
I think with the performance of the setting team earlier on the mats, I think there's a lot of stressed people out there at this moment.
Yeah.
And it's an experienced team, so I'm sure it'll all go fine. No matter what you do in a final or in a semi-final, no matter what you set, there's always some surprises. Semi-final for Jakob, didn't climb the first boulder. A lot of climbers did climb the first boulder. Jakob's in the final. Those other people aren't.
Yeah, to try and predict these as you go through is almost impossible. But it does make it super exciting from a viewing perspective. Obviously, the athletes are here. Some of them want to win. There is some prize money on the line here, but a lot of them are here for pre-season training. That's why there are so many international athletes. But they're not going to want to stand around and just do a bit of training here. They're going to go at it as hard as they physically can.
Absolutely, full bore. And obviously what we saw from having Olga on the sofa earlier on coming in at that last minute, she was visibly stressed, very stressed. And so it's not only a challenge for the competitors, it's a challenge for the setters. It's been a challenge with doing some of the live feed. We started the live feed for the qualifier at semi-final. Went a bit off off the hook.
Went a bit off pace for a second there.
But we pulled it back together and we got to the end of the semi-final and now we're here in the final. And I think it's going to be an amazing show.
Well, I mean, never say never. We're going to see the athletes at the moment. They have completed their observation period, 2 minutes per boulder. They will go back to an isolation zone, which is just off to the far right-hand side here of the Studio Bloc facilities. It's an incredible, crazy wall. If you do get an opportunity to visit Studio Bloc, this one's in Darmstadt in Germany, near Frankfurt Airport. It's like an absolute must. Obviously, we're here as part of the media team, but lots of guys are coming from all around of Europe, some overseas guys as well. And it's just an absolutely brilliant facility. This is what it looks like, and a humble industrial state, as per many climbing centres around the world. But once you get inside, the magic really starts to happen. And these guys who operate this wall, they run the wall, they're absolutely dedicated to amazing boulders, I would say that.
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, that's the real standout thing for this centre, is that they put on this event year after year after year, but the quality of the boulders is phenomenal, whether it's a V0 or a V1 or V2, like at the bottom end of the grade range, the quality is still as good, and the amount of effort they put into that. The spend on the holds is insane, but it is a quality event through and through. Every single boulder is an amazing boulder here. So if you ever get a chance to come to Studio Bloc Masters 2024 or beyond, then put it on your list.
I'm sold. Yes, it is absolutely incredible effort, and we are underway here. The 2023 final is underway. The first climbers on the mats are Katya Debovets from Slovenia and Nikolay Rusev from Bulgaria. Our first opportunity to see what here. And you can see how everybody is packed in there, upstairs, downstairs. They're sat on the lockers, they're sat on top of the changing rooms, they're sat on top of the bouldering wall. It is absolutely wild out there.
So yeah, men's one definitely won't be a soft boulder, I can tell you that. It looks brutally hard straight away. Nikolay straight into the starting position there.
Katya getting the swing of it. Oh, nice from Nikolay. There's that sort of toe hook move we've seen so much of this year. This is kind of welcome to the party boulder now, though. This gets really hard. Nikolay Rusev, the young Bulgarian, just 17 years old. Flash.
That is one way to start.
I was wondering about that. The judge had just pulled him up for the match there. He touched with his left hand. There's a screw on touching the jug right at the very top. He touched that with his left hand. I don't think the judge is actually happy with that. We don't really want to see that, to be honest. There's basically an overlapping screw on at the top of the boulder there. And judges are having a right old chat about it. But let's concentrate on Katya. For now, she just has to swing across this groove. I say just, it's an incredibly hard move. Oh! Always with a big smile on her face. So big smile when she caught that hold and lost focus essentially on the next move.
Well, Nicolai now has to attempt to repeat that flash, and I think there might also potentially be some sort of appeal after the event as well with that result. We shall see. We'll keep you updated. Katya with a big smile on her face from landing that initial jump.
So Nicolai has been asked to climb again. As Katya pulls through, Nicolai has to find a really kind of focused mindset here. He's obviously going to be pretty not happy with that as Katya Debovec gets it done. Four attempts in the end. And this time there's the top hold. The tape clearly is behind the right-hand pocket, not on the volume itself. Good work from the young Bulgarian. Showed the ability there, Gaz, to put that to one side for now and just climb the boulder again.
Absolutely. I mean, that wasn't a freakish flash, a one-off. It was like, I am here to win. I've got the level to climb on these boulders. So I think actually doing that second go again will probably be a real positive thing in his head. I mean, obviously, they've got quite a few rotations now to rest. So I don't think it'll have too much effect on him.
Yeah, it's pretty impressive. Pretty impressive start, really. Basically did the first boulder twice. Either he's incredible, that boulder is definitely doable. So the guys backstage in the isolation zone, they're going to know that these boulders are definitely on for a top. Roxana Beinens, the young German, getting lots of support as she comes out. And Matic Kota, Slovenian. It's time to get amongst it from those guys.
So Matic will obviously know that that boulder's been climbed. He'll know that he has to repeat it, do the same. That right hand that you're going to underneath the roof is really, really poor. I was very surprised. I was looking at it from one side and expected this to be quite a good pocket. I went and looked under the roof, I was like, oh. Wow.
Yeah, welcome to World Cup level boulders.
Yeah.
Both boulders have quite a high level of risk in them. I mean, sort of slightly low percentage move. This obviously swing and catch here for Roxana. Gets it done second time. And Matic has got a little 1-2 catch on the left hand and right hand down into that pocket that Gaz was just describing. Oh, that's nice. Really controlled. Oh, yes, from Roxana. Beinens smashes it, second go. Oh, there's the top, no mistakes on the top hold there for Matic. We are up and running here at Studio Bloc Masters 2023.
Yeah, that was a good tick there from Matic. He went with a slightly different sequence on that head wall. He went with the right hand to the big pocket and then crossed into the side pull with the left hand. So, wow, this has gone quick already. I mean, it seems to have kicked off like a bullet train.
Yeah, absolutely. Obviously, it's always interesting how the root setters play with the athletes. Do they have a little bit of a welcome to the finals boulder, or do they just go hard straight out of the traps? It's always a little bit of a game, a little bit hard to know, but both athletes did super well there so far. We're into our third rotation already. We have Jerne Kruder from Slovenia and Alana Yip from Canada. Alana's already down there at the far end, ready to go. Yoni's taking a little stroll.
Step for an afternoon walk, isn't it?
Look how close they are to the crowd, like in your face. Imagine having that many eyes on your backs when you're climbing. It's amazing how they deal with that.
Yeah,
Gaz, you've seven times British champion, done a lot of World Cups in your time as well. How did you find it with the crowd?
It is an amazing feeling, and I think for most people that compete and go through to the higher end, to the high level, you know, they actually thrive off it. Yeah, if you can't hack that pressure, then you're not going to make it to anywhere near this level.
Yoni absolutely cruising through that first move, didn't seem to have any bother with that whatsoever. There's that slightly different method, right hand Gaston, left hand out. Oh, the showboater before the match, that'll do.
That's like standing on a volume like that, fairly stretched, is such a risky move to make before you've matched.
I
think we've seen that a few times in the past. I'm on the mat.
Yeah, if you fall off while showboating, haven't got the match, that's an internet breaker. Wonder how Nikolay Ruzev's from Bulgaria's first guy out, wonder how that sort of mistake on the match on the top hold might come to get him later on in the competition. Time will tell on that, but now it's all eyes in the arena on Alana Yip. This boulder essentially designed to make you drop attempts. Kind of hopping quite high into that and coming down upon the footholds.
Yeah, it's not such a smooth move for her. Into landing those feet, it looks quite violent at the moment.
A lot of these jumps, obviously it's very easy to say this from this position, but need to be sort of gliding rather than powering across. Yeah, really high leg swing at the moment.
In for another go, 150 on the clock.
Let's go, Alana.
She's got lots of time to put this to bed. As we've seen already, that you do the jump, there's a very good chance that you are going to the top of the boulder. Alana really burning through this time now. Just 1 minute left on the clock.
That's the sort of move that you really need in the training camps before you get to a competition like this. And I suppose essentially pre-World Cup, this is a training camp for Alana. But yeah, it's one of those moves where you can learn that body position, how to use the hips. She's really generating momentum, driving the hips forward, but then coming pounding down onto the foothold. And obviously being a slab, it's more of a sort of a glide and a balance needed.
Very close then. She's in for one more go, 15 seconds on the clock. Come on, Alana.
Really, really quite frustrating, I think, for her to spend 4 minutes swinging about to no avail.
Yeah, absolutely, but she's walking off the mat. She's still got a smile on her face. She's got to pick herself up. She's got three more boulders to compete on. Here we are on the replay for Yone.
Look at that left foot with the showboater on that left foot. It's just a smear on a volume on an overhang.
Yeah, it's definitely a risky position to do that. I would have definitely got the match and then showboated.
Strolling onto the mats in the next rotation to attempt the first boulder, then the legend is Chloe Collier from Belgium and Ido Fidel. Zizo. It's a real big step up here from Ido. Into the main event now, these adult semi-finals. Done well in the youth scene, but it'll be an interesting season, see if he can convert that. The Israeli team really is on fire here at Studio Bloc Masters. They've really come in force and doing really well. Definitely a team to watch.
Yeah, definitely. I think we've had some very strong Israeli climbers in the past. And yeah, they've got a long way to go. I think we'll see some good results from them in the future. Chloe, very smoothly through that first move.
Yeah, with a flash of that move, just slightly less horsepower on the swing and just sort of glided into it. It's a really good angle into that zone hold. It's a proper bit of slab climbing after this jump. Ido looked like he had a lot of rotation there, but managed to secure it. Obviously quite good holds here. Men's number one really not causing too many issues. A few dropped attempts here and there, but seemingly quite straightforward for these lads. Oh, he goes with the showboat as well. They must have had a chat about it. Is that like in football where they all agree what the celebration is going to be if they score?
Maybe, yeah.
All eyes on Chloe Collier there. Stand up and pounce. Let's go, Chloe.
Oh, super positive on that top move, Chloe. I mean, you can hesitate a little bit maybe and not quite get there, but she was just like two hands, boom, I'm on the top.
Yeah, she looked super confident all weekend, actually. A little bit of carpet there is sensible on these mats, the vinyl mats, do get a build-up of dirt and chalk quite easily, so clearly showing her experience. She has done well at this competition before, second at the last time we were here back in 2020.
I think next year we'll have carpet on that Conwall. I think so.
Are you going to come and fit? Are you a carpet fitter?
I'll try.
Give it a go. A
couple of hundred euros under the table. Yeah. No problem.
Little brown envelope, you'll put some carpet to that.
Oh, yeah.
Get the van over.
Yeah. Anyway. I know where there's a bit of yellow carpet, actually.
We've gone a bit off pace with this conversation. Sarah Schopper from Slovenia is out alongside Jakob Schubert.
Quite hard to find words to describe somebody like Jakob with his ability across all disciplines, whether it be boulder, lead indoors, and lead and boulder outdoors. He is an absolute animal for climbing. He loves it. One of the strongest competitors around.
Sara joins the ranks of an incredible Slovenian lineup that's been basically dominant for a long time now. Obviously, Rijanja leading the way. Sadly, she has got an injury, so hasn't made it to this event. As Jakob looks to just find the method between those holds. That's kind of the only bit of doubt in this boulder. But the way he clamps with the right foot, presses down with the left foot on that screw on. I think they potentially would have climbed harder boulders in the warm-up area than that boulder. So now a really nice little step through method with the right foot. There is a few screw-ons because that is a dual texture volume, so the top of the volume is really slippery, but they have screwed on a little jib there. Oh, it does prove Chloe Collier and a few of the others made that look easy, but clearly isn't.
Yeah, Sarah's going through that move quite easily in the beginning, and then she's the first person that we're seeing falling off after in that boulder. Awkward step through on that first Frutti di Bosco volume at the bottom of the wall.
Sorry, what did you say? Frutti di Bosco?
Frutti di Bosco.
Is that not an ice cream in our case?
Yeah, it probably is. This sounds good though.
I like it. Oh, look, the way that left foot lands perfectly in that jump is amazing.
It's the dual texture on top of the volumes that give us the fruity finish. Just losing balance again there, standing on the first volume on the jib.
Yeah, the way that the overhanging section of that wall just pushes the shoulder out a little bit, it just makes you wobble off a little bit, the weight's pushing you away from the wall. Hard to stay really close, tuck the body in a little bit into the slab. So she gets on with this stand-up move this time. There you can see the overhanging section of the wall, just palming down on that a little bit to try and get established over that right foot. Leaning quite far back before trying to rock over there. It's going to be tight last minute here for Sarah. Sarah was really, really impressive last year. First at the in the UFA category at the World Champs in Dallas for Boulder. So she's obviously up and coming in the Slovenian ranks. Some of the more experienced Slovenian athletes actually not making it through to this final round. Some surprises to see people like Lucka Rakovic and Shia Tarkas not making the final. But then Katia, obviously one of the most experienced the team does, shows the depth of their squad. Looks like it's not going to happen for Sarah. The push and pull on that move in the feet is awesome to see. Tension across the hips. No showboating for Jakob, his business mode. One pair of climbers still to come. Madison Richardson, incredible, absolutely perfect, literally. Semi-final round with four flashes. And Anze Perhaš from Slovenia. Had a lot of nice chats with Anze this weekend. It's been absolutely diamond to talk to. Obviously, most people here are all staying in the same hotel, and it's been really interesting insight he's been giving into the team, his training, where he's at. And yeah, he was absolutely blown away. He thought he had sort of dropped the ball a little bit in the semi-final round. Thought the boulders weren't as hard as they would appear to have been because he cruised them, and yeah, very, very psyched obviously to make it through. That's a bit of fun in the arena as the beep for the rotation has started working. Anze's going for the drop down. That was insane. Drop down with a one hand release, did it completely static.
Looks like he went a bit high on that toe up, needs to go quite a bit lower. It looks better this time.
A bit of hand was touching that hard. We get too into the weeds of the rule book here, but about combination holds and holds touching things can get a bit confusing in there, especially when it comes to starts and zones and clusters of holds. But we'll go with what the judges are saying for now. Essentially, when does a hold touching another hold become a single hold itself? But, yeah, the reset's quite careful with where they place the tape from that one. As Madison falling off for the first couple of times today.
Yeah, she's definitely struggling with the start of this boulder. It was a little bit better.
Super cool start to the competition, really entertaining stuff. If you are joining us from around the world, you can drop your name in the chat, let us know where you're watching from.
Oh, that was much closer. A bit more effort put into that swing. Genau, sie schaut nochmal auf den Countdown, überlegt sich genau, wann sie
Pressure mounting here on Madison. It must be an interesting feeling, Gaz, I think, to crush the semi-final round and you come out last in the final. I always feel like that would be the pressure, like the position to come out where there's most pressure on you as an athlete.
Absolutely, especially if you're maybe not quite as experienced as some of the old guard. The Jakobs and Andres of this world, definitely more experienced. Finally, she's through that move. 38 seconds on the clock, she really just needs to make this count. She's looking good.
Yes! With 20 seconds left.
Great effort there, managed to keep herself together, keep the composure, keep drilling at that move, and got the top. Move on, three more boulders to go.
I feel like the skin's going to be burning a little bit there as she walked off. You can clearly see that the skin might be a bit of an issue as we go through the next three boulders. Clearly some hand touching there. I would be surprised if Nikolay Ruzev from Bulgaria wouldn't be appealing that top before. It depends really what was touching what at the top hold there. A bit of a nightmare judging-wise, actually. Don't really want to be in that position. Not fun as a judge, obviously, probably basically all volunteers here. You can see them all wearing the team shirts down the front here. Maximum pressure, the amount of cameras on you. Matt Groom there from Epic TV, right up in the, getting up in everyone's grills, putting the hard graft in, putting a shift in. Udo Neumann down the far end there by the 4 minute clock, one of the legends of the German coaching setup from years gone by. He's YouTube channel is absolutely brilliant if you ever want to be entertained by rock climbing movement. We are moving on to boulder number two. Nikolay Ruzev is back for Bulgaria, along with Katya Debevec. Dancing. Both guys on really footwork dependent boulders here. It's going to be sort of an extreme walking next 20 minutes. Oh, nice catch there from Katya Debevec. That zone hold is quite positive, although it's blocked by another little pinch. Oh, nice catch there from the lower foothold as well from Nikolay Ruzev. He's going so well, the young lad. As is Katya. This is going to get really interesting, this competition, quite quickly.
There's nothing like skipping a few moves to put the root setters under pressure, eh? They'll be nibbling their nails.
Yes, absolutely. Quite enjoying just looking at the chat there. Tip of the hat to Manuel, who's tagged where he's watching from with a baguette.
Nice.
No guesses there. Good work. Skip the zone hold completely there, Nikolay. The zone hold is like way out and left. It's a bizarre boulder, this one. Pretty strange boulder number two. Weird start, a bit of weird walking, and followed by some weirdness to finish.
It's not possible to miss the moves.
Yeah, do we make a stupid prediction and say I think someone might attempt to jump from the first stand-up position to the last hold? That all depends whether the walk across the volumes is how hard it is. it's quite easy to walk leftwards, they probably will, but if you start to struggle with that, then might be an option to go all out and just jump to the top from the first move. There's the starting position. So you've got to have 3 points on the start. So there it is, just maintain that touch. Start has to be in control on all 4 points. Roxana Vina goes well so far. Did top the first boulder in just 2 attempts.
That was super close.
Yeah, slow peel away there. Where's that cross through with the seat? We saw the same from Nicolay. Ooh, see the head was looking up at the next section there before concentrating on the move before. Not often you see the cross behind, usually it's the cross through from in front of the other leg, but that one's a wrap around the back. Just losing the balance there, obviously in the stand up, just body moving slightly further away from the wall than you'd like before moving up to the zone hold. Let's see what happens here with Matitz. What does he do with the zone hold? Oh, the concentration tongue. This is what the root setters were looking for, that palm down and then press to the top, slot hold to finish.
Roxana still struggling with this boulder, making a bit of headway. Passing that foot swap under the volume there, and then losing balance a little higher. Still 1:10 on the clock, still enough time.
Gaz talked quite a lot in the pre-show about the type of boots per problem, per hold, and definitely using the softer rubber here on this slab. Very common in indoor competition climbing these days with soft shoes. Matis Cotta goes up with the left hand. It's really struggling through that slab, actually, compared to Nicolay, who made it look like a walk in the park. Oh, that's close. Roxana definitely got the most epic chalk bag of the competitors we've seen so far.
Bit of a race on now for both these climbers. Only 10 seconds left on the clock. Roxana managed another go to touch the finish hold, couldn't hold it.
Went for the buzzer beater there, Matis, but yeah, wasn't going to happen with that many seconds left on the clock.
Again, next two competitors out, Alana Yip and Yone Kruder. Yone already with a flash.
Alana, we've work to do, in fact. only climber not to score anything on the first boulder, no top, no zone. So hopefully he'll be looking to obviously improve on that. Yone just gets into start position, no issues really. Still using the same method at the moment, so the sort of... I'm not even sure what we call that move, to be honest. It's sort of, we usually use the word step through, but it's sort of reverse flag cross under. That's not going to catch on.
I think in Sheffield it's got a name. The snake trapper. Still looking like Nikolai pulled a good one out of the bag on this boulder with going direct. Yeah, they still sticking to the better sequence. Back off for his second go.
It's obviously a tricky little transition this from Yone, having to use a toe hook. His hand departs the handhold as he shakes down to that foothold. Not looking like the ideal position there at the moment for Yone. Committing step up here for Alana Yip. The way that Katia Dibovic out first made that boulder look, both climbers out on the first rotation, sort of threw us off the scent of how hard these boulders are.
It's always interesting when you see a boulder like this, and this is down climbing boulder. We're going left and we're going down. Really, really awkward. Interesting style.
Yeah, the quads have to do so much work when you're lowering the body like that onto a foothold where you've got nothing to hold onto. Everything's in the right upper thigh there. Power going through the toes is just immense. Good work from Yone. He finds a transition this time, but as we know, this boulder is not over. Such bad feet and a slot to finish. Pressure mounts here for Yone. Realistically, only time for one more go after this, likely. Can't find it. Can't find the position. Just talking about the weight through the feet, switching up the boot for something a little stiffer so he can help him stand on those micro footholds. Lana just chinned herself a little bit there. Brush that off, carry on.
She's still smiling. Yone's got 45 seconds now in a new boot. Stiff boot on his right foot, soft boot on his left foot. See the difference that made on that step through there. Very, very easy. Loaded that right foot. Now this drop down's definitely cheeky. That's just like a slotted foothold. We all could stand on and find the positive part.
Lano is just touching that zone hole, but this is where Yone is hoping his stiff boot will work for him on this tiny little screw on jib. It's now or never for Yone Kruder. Tickled the letterbox. Couldn't deliver.
Well, three climbers through boulder number two. And only one to the top. Nikolai Rusev with that fantastic flash.
Yeah,
second catches, boulder.
Catch you as well.
Probably going to be worth a lot further down the line.
Three rotations still to go. Then out next, it's going to be Chloe Collier and Ido Fidel from Israel. Ida just 19 years old. Chloe kind of into those peak years now, 26.
Also die Startposition passt hier.
Different method there, stepping through rather than around the back there. Body completely rotated in a different direction.
Looking very comfortable at the minute, locating that slot foothold.
Bad these feet are. Chloe Connie just wobbles off going towards the zone hold. Ido's like mega collapse into that zone position, but instantly finds a way of standing up. This is looking really good. Her Ido Fido, but comes up short. That last move is a real heartbreaker.
Yeah, it's a long way, that finishing hold, and it looks really hard to generate off that right foot. The right foot must be absolutely terrible. Still plenty of time though, 2:30 on the clock. Ido's made some good progress on this boulder already. Chloe already on. Again, same starter style. Awkward cross through. Very close touch at the top hold there for Chloe.
Yeah, Chloe, so close to that. Securing that like double pinch zone. Interesting how easy, essentially, Katia Devovec made it look, and then other guys are just struggling to stand up into that. Yeah, essentially with the same method as before. It worked for him last time. Can he just find a bit more height on this jump? Oh, he can. Blue with the left hand, standing up on the right foot. 19-year-old from Israel. Looks really talented on the slab. Nice one, Zizo, for the friends at home.
We've seen in the men two young guns to the top of that final slab. Now to follow, we've got two of the older competitors, more experienced, with Andrzej and Jakob still to come. Interesting to see what they can do. But we, meanwhile, Chloe still has 1 minute on the clock. She really does need to try and get this in the bag.
Really tenuous step through, outside left foot, and the stand up. Oh, that is close. Looks like it's almost a bit of a coordination move there. Hard stand up, hit the zone, and stab out the right foot all in one move. So, so close here for Chloe. With a number of tops on the first boulder. It's really important to try and keep up with Katia Devovec even at this early stage in the competition. Doesn't happen though. Two more rotations on these boulders. This is the really nice stand-up method. He looked super confident on the feet all the way through those attempts.
Very solid on that move in the end. That's a good tick. Ido and Nikolai currently leading this men's field at Studio Bloc Masters.
Yeah, you can see the next two out, Sarah Schopper and Jakob Schubert. Sean McCall giving Jakob Schubert some hard truths about slab climbing in the pre-show there as well. Quite interesting to hear that. Obviously, he knows that he's a super talented climber, but essentially suggesting that Jakob's any weakness, he's the most decorated gold medalist in climbing history, so weakness is a... Yeah, it's a fine line, but what's a weakness for one and a crazy strength for another. But essentially saying, yeah, I would like to be that bad on slabs. But essentially saying his slab game is something that could potentially be worked on a little bit even more. Crazy, crazy talented. Hoping to prove everybody wrong here, Jakob. Sarah just tries to find that stand-up maneuver. go up on the top of that hole at the moment rather than in the little lip. Just slid down the dual tex. It's like essentially a slotted foothold, that one. Maybe we can get a little bit of a close-up of that foothold. What Jakob's trying to stand on there with the left foot.
Yeah, it's very awkward to lower the foot into the slot on that. You get stuck on the top like Jakob did. And then you've got weight on it, and then obviously try and release it. It pops off quite quick, and you're back on the mat.
Jakob facing the same way as we saw from Ido, facing in, crossing through on the inside of the... trying to crimp the back of that volume at the moment. I'm finding it hard to transition the way across, but it looks like he's going to try and go direct here instead. Crowd liking it, egging him on. Just peels off. I think he might try that again.
Yeah, I think he knows now. The crowd obviously giving him a bit of a beater there. A bit of vocal beater.
Remember you saying to me once before, Gaz, at the World Cup, you could really read the crowd when you got a feel for what they were doing, the way that they reacted to a position of a hand or a foot. You can kind of give you a bit of an insight into the boulder.
Yeah, many times, especially if you've got quite a few teammates in the crowd, then you can usually hear a lot of their voices. You can pick out people that you know very well, and they don't give you beta, but you know they'll cheer at the moment when you're doing something right, and you won't be hearing them when you're doing it all wrong.
Definitely silence when you're going the wrong way on a boulder.
But then you go the right way on these boulders, the whole crowd is cheering, so yeah, that's the way it is. As soon as he went to look to put the foot up, the crowd started giving it some.
There is that same method. He's eyeballing the zone. Might need that, but just going to try and roll it to the top. Coming up short, essentially. Slight stretch, that last move.
Yeah, I'm not too sure going down with the left hand there really helped him that much. It didn't really look like he could get too much spring.
Jakob had sort of caught between a rock and a hard place here at the moment. The method that he's trying might just about work, but at the same time, he's not securing the zone hold. Did get it earlier on in the boulder, so he doesn't actually have that to worry about. My mistake. Or does he? Nope. Totally wrong. He hasn't got the zone hold yet. Apologies there. Just waiting for my scores to update as he hits the top hold there.
He knows this is the way now.
Yeah.
That was much more controlled.
Doesn't have the time on the clock. Sarah Shopper.
He needs to move super quick.
Trying to climb a slab in under 10 seconds, very, very unlikely.
He knows that was one that got away. Screaming a little bit as he leaves the mat there. He knew he could have given a little bit more on that in the end. One more climber out on this second boulder. Second boulder of four. And usually Anze is pretty slick on a slab.
Madison Richardson and Anze Perhas now into the slabs. Pressure mounts, really. Nikolai and Ido in the men's competition have already topped this one. Katia Debovic, currently the only person to get the zone on women's number two and also the top.
Well, a top from Madison here could mix things up really well in her favour.
Carefully loads of foot, and then just before he wobbles off there, Ange just catches the underside of that volume. Let's see how Madison gets on this jump.
Ooh. Very close there. She had the hand in the slot. Yeah. Didn't quite land the foot.
As Ange looks to finish this one off. Still on his first attempt. This would be an incredible flash. Oh, it is an incredible flash from Andrzej Perhac from Slovenia. Qualified in the top spot from semi-finals and is in cruise control at the moment. Two flashes. Incredible. And Jakob Schubert back there is being followed by Andrzej just a minute or so after Jakob went away empty-handed, and that's going to pile on the pressure on the other athletes. Superb work from Andrzej.
Madison back on now. She definitely has an opportunity to really move forward in this field. Hit the last hold. Couldn't really land the foot. A little bit too much movement there, but it was a very good attempt again. Lots of time left. Madison back on now. A hidden foothold underneath that volume. Step through. There she has taken the top hold, matched it. Sorry, zone first. Now the top hold. She needs to get that match. Maybe needs to move that foot a bit higher. She does.
Good work here from Madison Richardson. Can she finish off body? Just collapsing a little bit, pressing down. Does get it done. Madison Richardson is definitely back in the game here.
That is a big top for Madison. Bumps her back up now into second place.
And after two bowlers, it's more open than ever. Our first starter from Bulgaria, super surprising, flashing, or maybe just in a few attempts, bowler number two. We didn't expect that. And on the women's slab, Katja coming out. I know a lot of you in this room and a lot of you on the stream thought, okay, is it too easy? What's happening now? Will the root setters be nervous? I was a little bit nervous, but then afterwards, really spectacular, really close to the zone, a lot of different tries and attempts, and now everything is open again. Madeline from Canada, amazing in boulder number one, and last second send in boulder number two, and now we're going to boulder number three. The white holds behind the cameraman for the woman, and boulder number three for the male. The man's is this black, beautiful Squadra Lapis battleship. Many moves, steep, powerful, and honestly, I hope our first starter isn't getting nervous, because now the pressure is on the top two boulder problems. Andrzej Perhac as well with two tops so far. They are the big favorites. Our root setters in the back are tweaking some holds off, so boulder number four can get climbed later without any disturbance. I don't actually know what we're waiting here for, so we can take the time and thank our sponsors, Climb Poles, for sponsoring all these beautiful climbing holes. We got a Bloc matting from Studio Bloc, La Sportiva, Lamsbräu, and many more. And of course, like, thank you for watching the stream on the internet and all the people over here. We've never had an audience this big, large audience, and I'm getting nervous again, honestly. So we hope that we can see the next starter soon. After the first two boulder problems, they were a little bit dynamic, delicate, and now we are moving into the steeper part. More moves, more power, more action, more show, more thrilling moments. And now we will see Katja again leading the field. So let's see what's happening now.
Thanks, Nikki. Awesome insight from down at the wall there as ever.
Katja Debevec on the right-hand side. Nikolai Rusev on the left as they face the crowd and are seen from the crowd.
So this men's boulder, as Nikki described it, the battleship boulder, was one of the boulders the root setters were tweaking right up to the final seconds. Let's hope their judgments are correct. So Katia, two tops so far, moves on to the third bowl. A very different style as Nikki's described. A lot more power. Nikola Ruzev is absolutely incredible scene so far from him. Katia's on a big powerful undercut struggle there. Seen quite a lot of that style so far. That's terrible. Gaston on the zone hold. Good work here from Katia. She is piling on the pressure on everybody here. Standing on the top of that dual texture volume to finish now. A real skatey finish. Oh, does bump up the foot. Let's go, Katia. Oh, incredible scenes from Katia Debevesh.
I think she's more surprised than anybody else in that room. That was an amazing flash. Doesn't really know where that came from, but she's absolutely on fire today.
Superb work. Great show as well from Katia. Caught that left hand with just caught the left hand one-handed and then just swung around before bringing in the match.
Nicolet just resting a little bit now.
Yeah,
showing the clock down into last 2 minutes.
Showing really good composure at 17 years old. Best results so far on the IFC circuit. Seventh for the Youth World Championships for Youth A. Definitely a chance that he's powering out slightly here towards the end of the competition. Climbing all day yesterday. Crazy qualifying format here at Studio Bloc Masters. So many hard bowlers to get yourself through to the semis. Further four bowlers in the semis and then four bowlers in the finals as well. It's got to start taking something out of you. I think even at 17 you might start to get slightly tired at some point.
Running the clock down to 1 minute on the clock now. There's the buzzer.
Alf gets, says the local MC. Gone from slab climbing to hard yarding. Holds attention on that move this time. Oh, this is looking good. There is a toe available out on the far left if he needs it. There it is. Oh, the box splits. Working his way through his boulder, but still moves to do. Looking tired. Elbows are up in the right hand. Let's go, Nicolay. Drills the screw hole for the left hand, trying to find something. Desperately hunting for something, and he's going to run out of time. Runs out of time, runs out of power.
That was an amazing show. What an attempt. Tried hard and hard and harder right until the last seconds. Just wasn't able to find enough on that volume to make an attempt at the finishing hole.
Do you wonder if he had another couple of seconds, maybe wouldn't have rushed that last move, if we see Katia with an incredible flash of the third boulder. The flash smile.
I think that was the surprise smile. That was that. I can't believe I've just done that.
Awesome. Next five climbers, especially in the women's competition, are going to know what Katia's done out there now, really. Especially when it comes down to Madison Richardson. She's got to stay in contention with her. It's going to be Roxana Wienand, who's coming out next. And Matic Kota Martins really struggling on the slab on the previous round. Got work to do to catch up with the field here. Three climbers already on two tops in the men's division. Really great to see that fight there in the previous round from Nikolay Rizev. Slightly unaware of the last remaining seconds on his big attempt.
That's a bit better by Roxana. She's managed to latch that hold, step through into the start position. Let's see what she's got left in the bank for these next few very physical, burly undercut moves. Giving it her all by the looks of it, and can't quite get into that zone with the right hand. Couldn't quite find the sweet spot.
Fatigue definitely starting to set in all of a sudden, you think, for these athletes, especially on a bowl first like that one. Double undercut, smearing for the feet. Another toe hook outright. Really fierce stuff.
Quite a lot of work to get into the position there where she fell off. Still didn't come away with his own. Like you said, saps a lot of strength through that burly section.
Matt, it's not enjoying this early couple of moves here at the moment. Struggling with the wrap and the cross through to the slot. Definitely not finding that at the moment. Even that move, Gaz, just so much power straight into the right hand. Gaston,
looks brutal that move.
Just smears for the feet. Really loads the arms.
That's it. Now this physical, burly undercut, swap feet, get the toe hook.
This time, Roxana, come on.
So close.
Judges won't be giving her that as the zone. The zone has to be in control, not just touched. Matic's really trying to find something to give him a little bit extra on this cross-through move.
Yeah, I don't quite seem to be able to find the right position there.
Yeah, Nikolay just went through that section so easily, didn't really register it as a hard move on the when we were watching his attempts. As Roxana looks pretty much done on this boulder, you would have thought. Starting to fall off lower and lower down. Still manages to cling on there.
Looking tired now.
Come on, this is a great effort.
She's wanting that zone, she's not going to get it. There's only 6 seconds on the clock. Both climbers on the mat now, we'll call it a day for that boulder.
Matic did just find the rollover move right at the very end there. Not much use finding it in the last couple of seconds, though, unfortunately. Comes an extra rotation, Alana Yip from Canada and Jernej Kruder, Slovenia. Let's see what they've got left in the tank. We've seen a couple of athletes start to fade a little bit now. They got something left. Both guys, no tops on the second boulders. Nothing on the board for Alana at the moment. Zero is all the way across, sadly.
A little bit more up Yone's street, this boulder, a little more physical.
I was just about to say the same for Alana as well. Hopefully some actual holds to pull on this time. Shoulder moves, so brutal. Yone Kuda found a little knee bar there to do the rollover, that's nice. Alana, yet powers through that lower section. Alana looking much more comfortable. All of a sudden, as I say that move up to the zone is clearly very hard.
Yeah, she didn't seem to really get that toe to settle.
Really got to pull across to her belly.
Yeah, as soon as she released with the right hand, the toe was coming out. Super powerful position that.
Lana, yeah, will be looking to lean on that Boulder World Cup experience that she has. Has made a Boulder World Cup finals before. Also went out to the Tokyo Games, ended up 14th out there as well. It's a super amounts of experience to be able to lean on.
Yeah, next first to step back up to the wall. And he's off and running. There's that tricky little knee bar behind Steinhold. Good techers.
Big release move. Big pop out to the left there in the men's boulder, but nothing on that volume at all, apart from just the shape itself. Now, let's see what Alana can make of this move this time. Can she really load that right toe? Pull and go. And just short. Dual texture as well, so the left-hand side of that has no texture at all, that hold. Great bit of root setting there from the team. Definitely a bit of a theme of the weekend here, the toe hook Studio Bloc Masters so far.
Yeah, definitely a popular method. Those climbers now 1:10 on the clock, or thereabouts. Enough time to send a boulder for sure. Yone taking his time to rest and apply some liquid chalk. That's the 1 minute buzzer.
Some amazing support from people in the crowd. Obviously, we're quite away from the comp wall here, but with incredible headsets on, and there's the screams coming from team members across the Studio Bloc audience is absolutely amazing. Yone now holds the swing as Alana goes up, try and secure that zone, but it's going to be all eyes on the Yone Kruder to see if he can find something through here. Some crazy techers at the moment, pushing and pulling on the feet. It's going to have to go quite fast as well. 15 seconds here for Yone. Went big, wrecked himself in the process. It's turned into a battle royale, this one.
Yone gave it absolutely everything on that boulder. And it was worth it. Came away with a zone, which potentially keeps him in check a little bit with the top three climbers, another top, and he can all change it up.
Chloe Collier is currently sitting in third position with just one top, looking to keep tabs on Madison Richardson, who's currently in the second position. And Ido Fidel currently in third place, two tops and two zones, in tops in four attempts and zone in three attempts. With Andrzej ahead of him, but Andrzej still to climb. Chloe just using the left hand on the back of that volume to establish into the starting position. Smart work from Chloe Collier. I feel like this move might suit Chloe. She's got to furl through this undercut now. Oh, the knee stack didn't quite work. Essentially a knee bar but with no foothold. Knee scum, I think we'll go for.
Stacked knees.
Ido didn't seem to get on too well with that first attempt. In for his second now. Something more like it.
Yeah, different method completely there. I'm not sure how this is going to work to get the right hand through. Leading with the feet first. Other guys have gone hands first and then jumped across.
Chloe back on. Up into that tufted shoulder. And then out rightwards into this really physical bicep-y section through this undercut.
Just not entirely happy on that undercut there at the moment, Chloe Collier. It looks like she's sliding quite a lot. Gone for the full left-hand arm wrap. Just really wrestling that undercut. Pressing the left foot now. All drifts away from it.
So 1:18 on the clock. Chloe pulls back on. Still got time. No female have been onto this zone yet. Everybody's tickled it up to now. Can she get a wrap on this undercut? Make that toe hook really work. Now's the moment.
Can Chloe match Katia up there? Oof,
so close.
I have to say, Katia Lebovec is top of this boulder. It's looking more and more impressive. So is Nikolay Ruzev. Does interesting things to the atmosphere when the first two climbers out do so well on the boulders. It's, you know, in theory, as it goes, the first climbers out are the ones who have suffered most in the semi-final round, coming through in sixth. This final seems to have flipped itself on its head a little bit. The upside down results, as some people like to call it.
Ido taps out, says thank you very much to the crowd and moves on. Meanwhile, Chloe is back on, 10 seconds left.
Chloe fighting for a zone here. She's obviously in third position at the moment, so needs to really try and do something to maintain that position. Oh, that looks absolutely brutal under there. Chloe Collier walking away very, very frustrated. Clearly, you can see that, read that on the face. Matt Groom from Epic TV there, getting right up in amongst it. She really was looking for the zone hold, you would have thought, right at the end there, because we've got Sara Schopper coming up next, who's just sat below her in the results field at the moment. Wants to keep the pressure on. So Jakob Schubert in an unfamiliar sixth position at the moment. One top flash it was. And Sara Schopper from Slovenia in fifth. Zero tops also.
I'm going to make a prediction.
Jakob, are we putting money down?
Jakob will do this boulder.
Let's see how Sara gets on with this undercut now. Chloe Collier starting to slide under that, the underside of that volume. You can clearly see from the body position that it's not an in-cut volume. Jakob just busting through these early moves. Straight jumped into the wrap on the left hand there. Smooth climbing perfection currently here from Jakob. Using the side pulls of each of those volumes, looking very, very comfortable at the moment on this boulder. Jakob Schubert, not still on his first attempt. The most gold medals of any male to ever enter competition climbing in lead. Fighting away on the boulders, goes for the cross through the left hand and gets our first top from men's number three, Gaz, you called it. Should have put some money down at the bookies.
Absolutely.
That was awesome from Jakob Schubert. Shows his talent. Puts him into the two top club, immediately rockets him up into third position. Two flashes. Piles back on the pressure, Jakob.
Yeah, it's all setting things up nicely for the final boulder. Puts him into the top three there. Solid performance on that third boulder by Jakob. A little bit more powerful, fingery.
Moved away from the slabs.
Lots of hard moves.
Move away from the
holds,
slabs.
Holds to pull on.
Got some fun, something he can get his mitts into. And
yeah,
just,
totally. Yeah.
Just tear down on them. Superb work. Great show from Jakob. So it is going to be 1 minute 45 and it's going to be all eyes on Sara. Some quick work can move her up much higher. Find a top here. Get yourself much higher up the leaderboard before we move into the final boulder. See, really uncomfortable on that undercut at the moment. Left foot didn't join the right on that slightly further right volume.
Yeah, really struggling there to attempt to make the match. Some of the females have buried the arms behind that volume to come in. Sara was still holding it out on the pinch. Always hard to read how to use those holds. Such a simple shape, but brutally hard to work with.
Yeah, it's all about the compression between the arms pulling up and the feet pushing down. Straight back. Maximum force going through the back. Likely the final attempt here for Sara.
Yeah, enough time for some magic, maybe. Let's see.
Brings the left foot in this time. Has to go for maximum bowl on the biceps. Doesn't happen for Sara Schopper. Still no tops on the board for her. We move into our final rotation this time. Look at this, just immense control from Jakob Schubert and every element of this boulder. Never really looked phased or really looked like he was trying that hard at all.
Yeah, that was pure cruise mode on that style.
He could have clipped quick draws halfway up that boulder, I think.
He was doing that, yeah, absolutely.
Final rotation then. Starts to get very interesting because it's Madison Richardson who's looking to pile on the pressure to Katya Debevec to go into the final boulder. And it's going to be Anže Perhač from Slovenia, who's just been absolutely on fire at the moment. He is sitting down in second place, though, so he needs at least a zone hold here to stay in contention. Madison, one of the surprise athletes through to this final in first place as it stands. A little bit more composed on the undercut, but still Berlin here. Whoa, sticks his own just about and quickly, instantly goes from a drag into a crimp. Superb work here from Madison. Whoa, just tries to flick to the last hole, doesn't use the small screw at all, uses the knee. Wasn't necessarily a perfect way to climb the boulder, but it got the job done, and that is what the only thing that matters at this stage in the competition. And Madison Richardson completely back in the game as Andrzej Perhacz keeps the entertainment for us here coming. Oh, that is where Jakub Schubert bumped up his right hand. Brilliant top.
Well, that's really mixed it up for the final boulder for the women. Well, three tops, three zones, three tops, three zones. And then the only thing dividing those two climbers, Katja and Madison, are attempts.
So a boulder of this nature, athletes really will probably run down the clock, leaving them enough time for one, possibly two attempts. And Andrzej needs this to keep the pressure on the young Bulgarian. Interesting, he goes, campuses up to that left hand edge of that volume early. That's progress compared to the previous attempt here from Andrzej. The zone hole is absolutely dire crimp. Looks happy on it though. Andrzej Perhacz, incredible so far. Pumping the right foot, just trying to find the body position. Another toe hook. Will he find the method to roll through? It's risky. Oh, and bins it off the top. Absolutely bins it off the top. On the roll through, the left foot was still tucked behind the volume. Didn't look like he really had the time to react to it, removing the left hand and then go. He just went with it still tucked in.
I think he knows that was it, but he's going to give it one more go. 40 seconds on the clock. He's got a lot of climbing, a lot of technical body positions to work his way through to get to another chance at that top move. He needs to climb really quick for this.
A top here would be ridiculous. Yeah, not going to happen. The amount of effort they used on that last boulder, that last attempt. Good show from Andrzej, but not what he wanted. But this really was incredible. Madison just decided to flick it off the toe hook. There is a small screw-on available for her that we saw Katia Debovec using. Just launched it into the Gaston for the top. Amazing. It's a bit of a knee scrubber on the zone hold just to bring the right foot up. Gets it done.
Oh, and we're back here on the mat. I think Gas is losing his voice already. Maybe yelling a little bit too much, but Mike is still going strong. And going strong is Jakub Schubert. Seems like a comeback after bowler number two, the slap, and gotta say, like, Anze had a stellar performance in bowler number one and bowler number two. And now, when he dropped the top of bowler number three, everything is back open on bowler number four, which will be a dynamic bowler problem for the male category. And in the women's female category, we got Katja putting pressure on everyone, but Madeline is keeping up. Even in bowler number three, which was really, really burly. We've seen it, Chloe, Alana, everyone. Like, the slope was so steep, and it's a lot of surface. So if you want to know how those boulders got created and who did this, I suggest hitting YouTube. You will see it in a few weeks. We will do and publish and present and edit a behind-the-scenes route-setting process video series so you can see how the setters came up with these crazy boulder problems. And boulder number four for the females, the women category, is also crazy dynamic.
on dual text hold set by the chief setter Reini Fichtinger. Of course, the whole team was always tweaking together. And I think everything comes down now to boulder number four between Katja and Madeline and Anze and Jakob. Sorry for any mispronunciations, sorry for any mistakes, but now we're going into the thriller, boulder number four. Dynamic action happening soon here at Studio Bloc Masters 2023. And I will give back to Mike and Guess. Guess, I hope your voice will be strong enough for the next boulder number four.
Thanks, man, I'll try my best. It's going, but yeah, we'll keep going ourselves.
Yeah, it's all right, because we've got whiskey under the table. Just a couple of swigs of that, you're good to go. As Katja Debovec looks to secure this competition, as does Nikolai Ruzev, who has to pile the pressure on Anzhi with a top here. It is going to come down to the final boulder. Men on the right on the crazy swing and catch. And the women have got a bit of a paddle move as well, potentially, in the middle. Rootsets have done an incredible job so far. So much pressure on them before the competition. Let's go then. Nikolai on the right. The big swing. 1-2, and then across the corner. Crazy move. Oh, yes, look at this. Katja Debovec is on fire this weekend. A catch into a compression move with a left-hand undercut, and then a campus into a coordination move. This is route setting in 2023. So we're imagining, as we were told, the men swing across to the first volume, slow it down, and then immediately, before gaining a static position, launching out again. That's looking better.
Well, not only do you need to jump into that second set of volumes, you also need to finish the movement in a press. Not like you're jumping down to a jug or anything like that, but into a standing press, so definitely a very complex movement.
If Katja can get this boulder done in a few number of attempts, that will win it for her. Trying to go feet first rather than sort of coordinating paddle jump move. Nice from Katja. Standout athlete in the finals, does secure the zone hold. Maybe the judge will give her that heels in the way at the moment. Katja wriggles the heel out. Can she progress through this boulder and seal this competition up here? Katja Debovec. She could win it based on the number of attempts the next climber, Madison Richardson, has already used. That left-hand undercut looks so bad, barely even used it. The top hold is in sight. She's eyeballing the top, eyeballing the win here. Oh, went for the 1-2 to finish, Katja Debovec.
That was so, so close from Katja. She knew what to do. She just didn't quite hold that 1-2. 1:40 on the clock. She's got plenty of time to have another attempt. Quite a slow boulder, though.
So much involved in that women's boulder. It is crazy the number of different momentum moves involved in that. One out of the start, potentially one into the zone hold, although Katja has found a way to go static, then another coordination move to finish. Talk about high risk.
Nikolai seems to have started to get his head around this boulder, started to learn the movements. Can't quite get onto that second stack of volumes and into the press. Press hold next to the zone.
That design of volume is so useful for route setting, for constantly building out the wall. If the jump doesn't quite work, you can keep adding a layer. Bring the climbers further away from the wall. Trying something slightly different, doesn't like the parkour method. Katja then, this is it. 30 seconds, all or nothing there. Will leave the door open if she doesn't find a top. Competition is going to come down to the next few seconds here for Katja Debovec. Tries to go into the undercut early, that doesn't work. Shaking slightly on the right foot. Katja sticks it! What a moment! Katja Debovec takes it with just the most insane finals round. So much involved in that boulder. So much control needed. Only a few seconds left on the clock. Katia Debevec, four tops in nine attempts, four zones in eight attempts. What a round that is for the Slovenian.
She was so surprised when she caught that left hand. It was like, oh no, I'm here.
Let's have another
quick
look.
Match is the replay.
So much barn dooring going on in this last move. Flicks the hips up and then the left hand just catches. What an incredible bit of route setting that is. And what an incredible bit of climbing that was from Katia. Such scenes here. What a moment. One of the very best here at Studio Bloc Masters, Darmstadt. It was getting close on attempts as well. Madison Richardson could get four tops as well, but she's already used 11 attempts. Katia has smashed it. Other podium places, of course, still up for grabs. Such great work there from the veteran, Katia Debevec. Cannot overstate how impressive that was. Well, try and regain some sort of composure because we are continuing with Roxana Vinand. See how she gets on with this boulder. So many moves involved in this. Finds a static way of doing that second move as well. Oh yeah, they are preferring this feet first method. Yeah, really composed, strong climbing so far here from Roxana. Roxana currently in third place with that zone hold. Trying to pump something out of that left-hand undercut.
Zip off that foot.
Maybe hasn't quite read it in the same way that Katia did. With the compression move to finish.
Yeah.
A little ooh and an ah there as Matic
has a go. Comes close to shinning himself.
As he tries to rip the skin off his shins 5 metres away from where he started the boulder.
Yeah. Did look good though. It looks like he was attempting to go down into a crouch. Landing position on that second set of wooden volumes. It's a long way over there.
Love it or hate it, this style seemingly is here to stay. When it works, it's crazy impressive. When it doesn't, it's just people flapping around the start. That's it, starting to generate a little bit more of that middle volume.
Roxana back on, 1:25 on the clock. Inverted through this initial roof section. She's been here before. This is impressive climbing to get back up here again. Taking a moment to chalk up. Loads of time on the clock. This is it.
What method will she try and deploy for this last move this time? There's literally nothing on that left hand. Katia read it like a book, that last move. Knew exactly what to do. Took her two attempts to get it. Potentially a little bit of inexperience showing here. It's Kotter. Another go at the big swing. Look how high his feet are going, generating momentum across there. Very, very risky move to put in a final this in men's number four, the big show. 10 seconds now for Roxana Wienand. Chalking up, but needs to go. It's a great competition, though, from the local German, Roxana. Really building on that experience that she gained at the World Cups in Boulder and Lead over the last year.
Yeah, good show in the final for Roxana there. She must be happy with that result. Currently sitting in third place.
Fist bumps the crowd all the way through. Good to see. Fist bump for Matic as well. What a weekend it's been so far. 3 years break since everybody was last here at the Studio Bloc Masters, and it has not disappointed. It's been absolutely epic.
Well, we've definitely got a couple of good male competitors that are quite good at flying to come in this last boulder. Yerne being one of them, and then Anze being the other. He is exceptional on this style.
Yeah, Nicolai can no longer win this competition unless there's some sort of a judging countback or whatever from the first boulder. But for now, let's just concentrate on the moves, not necessarily the results. You know, this is a pre-season training event for a lot of these guys. We've got the power from Ilana. Yep, they're deciding to campus match in. I actually think that was the intended method from the root setters.
Yeah, it certainly looks like it.
Kruder almost sort of held that whilst falling off. I think he got the idea. Big puff of the cheeks. Pretty scary jumping across there. It was one of those in the qualifying round, slightly even crazier than this.
Yeah, I think we definitely saw the method there.
Straight back on, gives you an idea. He wants it. Oh, when it works, it's amazing. Yerne Kruder loved it. Only a few attempts to learn that move as well. Crazy Kruder. Can he finish off this competition in style? He's looking good at the top of this boulder here. The legend from Slovenia, Yerne Kruder, finishes his competition with two tops and one of the most impressive on boulder number four. Yes.
That bumps into the top spot for now. He's very happy with that. And so are the crowd.
Oh, yes, for Milana. Goes for the 1-2-3. Probably use that hold as a bit of an opportunity to rest, because we know there's a bit of a coordination, high-risk move to finish as well. Let's go, Ilana. No top so far in this competition. It'd be good to finish with one. Oh, that is a hard position. Read the move correctly, the foot slip just as she went for that top section.
...120 on the clock. Ilana making sure these holds are clean as they can be. She really does want to try and get this top, and I think it's a possibility looking at that performance.
Lana got to dig so deep now. Clearly breathing hard on the mat with just a minute to go. The final effort of this weekend for her. Really long boulder as well, there's a lot of moves. Even just that first compression move is pretty sick. A jump into a campus. Just three fingers dragging that hole. That is going to be it for Alania. Great weekend, not the best finals that she was looking for, but absolutely sick training day nonetheless. Let's have another look at this crazy swing and jump. 1-2, and then pop again into the corner and just somehow landed it with the sort of base of his hand. Amazing. Top section was absolutely kind of straightforward in the end for Yone.
Yeah, very, very solid onto that top hold. Really, really psyched. Cracking finish that was.
Puts him in first for now, but Ido, Jakob, Anjay can all potentially pass him. What a finish. Is anybody going to be as good as Yone at flying across the corner?
Well, the first one we get to see is Ido Fidel, the young guy from Israel. Let's see how good he is on this style. Some people referring to it as a skate style. Let's see what he can do.
Chloe can put herself in to third place here. Ido's close straight away. Oh, Chloe decides to go for the feet first method as well. Love the fact that there's two different ways of doing this boulder. I like to see that in route setting sometimes. Not all about forcing the same move for everybody. Give the athletes an opportunity to think through the moves. Chloe drops the foot out of the hole, makes space for the hand, a little campus into it. Such a long boulder. It's all going to come down to this last move, really. With that zone, she moves immediately into the bronze medal position where she will probably stay. Come on, Chloe. For now, at least. Quite a confusing last move, this one. Hasn't quite found it. Ido has found it, though. Ido Fidel with a top here. Misses the hold out on the left. Temporary first position. What a weekend it has been for Zizo from Israel. Incredible. Ido Fidel straight into the top spot. Wild scenes once again here. Studio Blockmasters.
Everybody yeah, the young guy from Israel, super happy with that. What a great performance. Really lays down the gauntlet for the athletes to come after him. Particularly Slovenia and Anjay. Meanwhile, the crowd is silent, waiting for Chloe to step forward once again onto her final boulder.
Super cool move there again, start of this boulder. Barely a bad move this entire weekend. Quite swiftly through that section. That's going to be potentially putting Chloe in a better position for this final hole. That hole in the middle there is only textured on the underside and it's sort of a sloping undercut, so doesn't really work for a left hand for this next move. Potentially got to pounce into that last move. It looks like she might be able to find something because she's stemmed so far out wide. Oh, the arm bar. The arm chop on the right hand to try and push herself up to that last move. It would seem that like Katia Depovic's method of compressing and sort of jumping and compressing that final move is the way.
Yeah, well, Chloe made herself at least move in the right direction, but I don't think she was ever going to get the distance to that finishing hold.
On the replay. Are we on the replay? Just been looking at the scoring screen. This isn't a replay. This is live, 15 seconds left. Chloe, this is it for Chloe Collier. All or nothing on the last move. Will she try something else? Goes for the pounce, comes up short. Chloe Collier currently in bronze medal position. Sarah coming out after her has the potential to surpass her as well. See what we're going to see on the replay here. This here. Oh, that's the catch on the right-hand side that we slightly missed earlier from Ido. After that, he absolutely just puffed it to the top, to be honest. Don't think he even used a hold on the left there. So it's a quick push to the top. Thank you very much. I'll take first position. So four climbers to come out. Two men and two women as the pressure builds here in the arena. Sarah Schopper and Jakob Schubert then. Jakob has the potential to go into first as well. Can't believe how tight this is.
Certainly is making for a very, very exciting finish. Jakob starting to get that swing going.
Jakob did well there. He's quite open to the fact he's not a huge fan of this style. Wouldn't really be like to what he sees as a final boulder, potentially compared to boulder number three. Nice to have a little top here for Sarah to finish the competition. Oh, nice little 1-2-3 there for Sarah Schobert. Oh, Jakob's looking tidy that time.
That was really close from Jakob. He knows it as well.
Jakob said the most fascinating thing to me yesterday, which really just summarised him for me when I asked him how he gets on in the qualifying round with so many people saying there's so many boulders, it's really hard on the skin. I said, like, how are you getting on? You're having a good time? He said, I love climbing. And that was it. And you just think, there's just so many boulders he wants to go. He wants to try them all. He says, I love climbing. This is perfect. Oh, yes. Oh. A few hundred people here collectively held their breath at the same time there as Jakob slowly peeled off backwards. What a move that is.
But certainly got that pretty dialed now.
Sarah Schopper looking really solid actually on this boulder. The interesting release of that left foot on this last move. Can she find that little flip of the left hand? Does find it, but a bit too much momentum with the left foot so high. We saw Katia bringing that left foot down. Auf gets the Jakob Schubert. Oh, just hit the right-hand side of that hold where there's no texture. 1:30. He knows he's on for this here, Jakob. Yes, the legend that is Jakob Schubert makes it stick. Can he finish this off? It's going to be so interesting where we are with the number of attempts compared to Ido Fadel there. Got to finish it first, though.
Quick slip with that left hand, managed to hold it. Get the palm down, roll over. One hand in the top.
Can he finish it off here? Jakob Schubert from Austria. Superb work. Not his favourite style, jumping across the corner there, but shows his talent. And it is down to the number of attempts to zone that puts him currently in second place. Ido Fadel clings on by one attempt to the zone hold. painstakingly close to a first position there for Jakob, but I think he'll be pretty happy with that as a little warm-up tour before the circuit begins. But it's all eyes on Sara with just over 15 seconds remaining. She's been on this last move a number of times now. Not going to happen. Great work from the young Slovenian. Sara Schopper taps out. No tops in the round for her this weekend. Absolutely superb effort to get through to this final. Let's have another look back at Jakob. The amount of attempts he had here, crazy to make this work. His right foot didn't even hit that sweet spot of that first triangle either. When it works, that move just looks amazing. Did end up using that left-hand volume as well. Perfect climbing, really textbook stuff from Jakob. No mistakes. This is it then. Madison can get four tops, but can't progress past Katia, but Anje can do this. A top quickly would push him past Ido.
Definitely a good final boulder this for Anje. So smooth around the parkour boulder in the tour yesterday. I think this is very up his street.
There's Anje in the background. Nowhere near it that time.
No.
Attempts in hand here for Anje. Superb work from Madison. Definitely one of the standout athletes so far this year, Madison Richardson. Let's see what she makes this last section. Actually getting closer with attempts in hand. Anje, I think looking at this from our angle, he's used three attempts at the moment. That's four. I'm counting this on the fly as well with you guys at home. This is so close. Oh, that might be it for Anje. With Yone's four zones as well, Anje needs to get the zone here to get himself in contention on the podium. Interesting, Anje's feet there aren't even hitting that smaller top triangle. He's right up on the high section of that initial ledge volume. Anje then with 40 seconds. Crowd gets right behind him, still not using that small triangle. Try something different. Other guys have gone palms up. Anje needs this to get on the podium. Madison playing for pride here as well. She's already in second place. Can't go any further than that. Just 16 seconds left of this competition. Madison goes big, ends up going home in second place. Anjay was possibly the favorite all the way through, but can't find it on the last boulder. And Ido Fidel takes it for Israel in the men's competition. Madison takes second. What a show from the root setters. Superb work all the way through. Anjay looking absolutely gassed at the end there. Athletes walking away absolutely broken. Ido Fidel, three tops, three zones in seven attempts. Just one attempt to a zone for Jakob Schubert. Somehow, it's always Jakob. How's he always there? Jakob Schubert with seven attempts to zone holds in the end. Jerny, two experienced old guards in second and third, as we have a quick break here in the commentary position before we bring you the ceremony and lots of interviews with Nikki of what was an incredible finals round. I have to say, amazing work from the organisers and the route setters. There's that sketchy top from Nikolai Ruzev. We'll take a quick break. Don't go anywhere, though, because we've got this ceremony and some more interviews from Nikki. So what a final it was. It was absolute scenes from start to finish here at the Studio Bloc Masters here in Darmstadt 2023. A few years since we've been here, and what a final, Gaz. First things first. I mean, the route setters, we saw Olga Nimitz just before the competition started. We saw the route setters themselves just literally seconds before the curtain came down and the competition got underway.
They were still pulling on.
They were literally had the shorts on, drills in hand, trying to make it work, and they absolutely nailed it.
Yeah. I mean, when Olga sat down on the sofa, she was like, you know, seriously stressed, obviously. There's always a lot of pressure on the route setters. Even when it's all going perfectly well, there's still pressure. And it was all going wrong in the reset, and they were tweaking right up until the last minute when that curtain was just ready to come down. And Olga and the team, they made it work. They nailed it. Absolutely nailed it.
It was absolutely brilliant. Let's just jump straight back down to the wall. We've got Nikki down there one more time. Nikki.
Well, we're back down here at the wall, the last preparations before the winner's ceremony, and I gotta excuse myself because I've been carried away after the first three bowlers. I didn't know anything about names, rankings anymore, and now we got a surprise winner from Israel, Ido, and I thought Madison was so close catching up with Katja. So Katja coming stronger back after her injury, strong contender to go to the Olympic Games, in my opinion. And Ido from Israel, I don't know how old young he is, but this was amazing. This was mesmerizing, like this last boulder number four, call it whatever you want, skate move, parkour, guess lost his voice over it. It was spectacular. Great to see, and I think the show was amazing, and it could be a great indicator what's happening this season on the IFSC stage with the following competitions leading up to the World Championship in Bern in July or August, anytime this year. And Reini is waving. The whole setting team seems really relieved. We had a few discussions after the women's semi-final round. Was it too difficult? Was it too easy? Of course, it was more like a flash round, but with a final round, which was a little bit tougher, I think the route setting team showed a good effort and a good show. I was highly entertained, and I hope you were entertained as well. And to make this all possible, we got to thank Studio Bloc, of course. We also got to thank the sponsors, Climb Holds, for providing us with so many beautiful different holds to create that many beautiful different moves. Bloc Matting for keeping us safe, La Sportiva, T-Wall for the walls, and of course Lamsbräu, a local beer production, one of my favorites around here. And I hope you on the stream enjoy the show, enjoy the MCs, guests, and Mike. Thank you so much for delivering and carrying us through 4 hours of semi-finals and finals. And I think we are almost there with the winner's ceremony. And I'll be back after the winner's ceremony to do a quick interview with Katja and Ido. Catch you in a bit. Nikki out.
Oh, what a dude. What a dude.
Such a legend.
So great work, Nikki. And thank you, obviously, to you. That is not easy work down there on the mat, elbowing people, trying to get in front of everybody for the final shots. Carrying on the conversation we were just having then, Gaz, obviously, we've seen it there. Nikki said it as well. It was an absolutely brilliant event. But Nikki just alluded to it. To put on an event like this, it is a commercial climbing centre. This is not a World Cup. The amount of money they have to put on the line to make this possible for us to be here, obviously, everybody, so many volunteers. The level of organisation is absolutely crazy, and they've just done an absolutely brilliant job once again.
It's always an extremely professional event, and they do a super good job. Obviously, the sponsors are really, really helpful with it, but it also comes down to the support from you guys turning up and competing and having a really, really good day and a good weekend.
And watching as well. I've really enjoyed looking at the live chat as we've gone through. Thank you so much for everybody who has commented and got involved and watched the stream. That's a nice way to spend a Sunday, whether it's evening, morning, or middle of the day, wherever you are around the world. I know there's loads of people watching from all over. We are just waiting for the ceremony to kick off here, and then Nikki is going to do one final job for us, which is to grab an interview with our winners, Katja Debovec and Ido Fidel. But, Gaz, once again, it's been an absolute pleasure, isn't it, I think?
I think so.
Not for you, possibly.
It's been quite hard work for me.
Where's that whiskey? I think we got it. It's just over there.
Oh, yeah. My voice has left the building, I think, and it's about time we did too.
Yeah, absolutely brilliant. But it looks like we're going to stick with us a couple more. Tantalisingly, just out of reach, one of the organisers has brought us a final coffee of the evening. I think something stronger might be ordering. Nikki mentioned there that there is a beer sponsor. I wouldn't have known, actually. I've been paying through the nose all weekend for that.
I've not seen many beers going down.
You need to get to the airport, straight back to Spain and get on those routes. Myself and a few others will be heading straight back to London. But there you can see it. That's your route setting team. And that is a nice touch on the far left-hand side of your screen. The crew of route setters. Olga has been feeding us information all weekend. What a show those guys have put on. And there's been more of those actually setting the qualifiers as well. The qualifying tour, 80 boulders they put up. The level is ridiculous as well. There's our guy on the mats, Nikki. That's a nice touch to show everybody who's involved in making things like this possible. This route setters are definitely smiling a lot more than they were just before the competition. Olga's got to basically pack her bag and head straight to Sheffield to set the next competition, which is absolutely ridiculous.
That's it. She's off to the Quiff. And the Quiff will be happening next weekend. That'll be Saturday for the qualification round and Sunday for the finals as well. So make sure you get yourself onto YouTube and tune into the live feed for that one. Something to look forward to over the next weekend.
So our local MC putting in one final shift to do the big presentation, the winner's ceremony. Oh, you caught me looking way too relaxed there. I was just slowly drifting into the back of this chair thinking we're nearly there.
It looked like you were about to nod off, actually.
Yeah, not far off, actually. It's been a long weekend.
Some late nights. Yeah, it's been a pleasure. I mean, as it always is, coming to Germany and working a studio block, seeing the quality of the event, the quality of the boulders, it's just exceptional. Ever want to put it on your list, put it at the top.
Yeah, look at the amount of people who put it on their list there. Just next to the MC, looks like Robert is going to be handing out the prizes, one of the owners here. The ceremony, though, third place and a podium once again here at the Studio Block Masters for Chloe Collier. Great battle, especially early on in this final. One top for her, two zones, a flash of the first boulder, and a zone on that final boulder gets her onto the podium. Great pre-season work once again from Chloe, taking a check. Second place though, Madison Richardson, straight from the Doc Masters Championship last weekend, representing Canada, three tops. And the top on boulder number three will probably stay with me for quite some time. Flicking for the last hold. A shoulder press, not using the footholds on offer whatsoever. Superb work from Madison. Three tops and four zones. 11 attempts for the top and 12 attempts for those zones, including one flash. The nationality of the top step of the podium is still Slovenia, but this time it's Katja Debovec. The seasoned pro still at the top of her game. Superb work for Katja, the only climber to get four tops, and look at that, smiling from the first moment till the last. Such scenes here at Studio Block Masters. Four tops, four zones, nine attempts just for the tops and eight attempts for the zones. What a show, taking away 3,000 euros. That will do nicely. Your top three, Katja Debovec, Madison Richardson, and Chloe Collier.
www.marcus-reinzettel.com. Nicht, dass ich hier irgendwas falsch mache ganz zum Schluss. Der dritte Platz beim Studio Bloc Masters 2023. And the third place for on the Studio Bloc Masters 2023 goes to Slovenia.
Moving on to the men's presentation in third place with that crazy top on boulder number four. Puts the Slovenian legend Jernej Kruder onto the first step on the podium. That's third place. Two tops for him. Crucially, those four zones. Great scenes, as always, from Jernej. Always up for a good time, whether it's on the bouldering competitions, World Cups, outdoor, multi-pitch, trad, sport climbing, deep water surfing. He loves it all. Proves that you can be powered by pizza, Jernej Kruder. Massive pizza for lunch just an hour before the competition. So interesting to see Jakob Schuber in second place. That flash of boulder number three. The only top, and he did it first try. Mind-blowing stuff occasionally from Jakob Schuber. To flash that boulder was absolutely legendary. Three tops for him, three zones, seven attempts for both of them. Got on with that final boulder in the end as well. The parkour jump across the corner, not his preferred style, but still got it done. And if you were a betting person, you probably wouldn't have put first place down to the young 19-year-old from Bedell. From Israel. Ido Fidel. Zizo takes it. He was incredible on the slab. That helped him a lot. Three tops for him. Three zones and just seven attempts for the top. Jakob Schubert nudged out by one attempt to a zone hold. Crazy how close his competition was on the final boulder. That's your men's presentation. Gaz, one more word.
Thanks for coming.
Head to the pharmacy. That's us in the commentary box. We will leave you with Nikki, who's going to do an interview with Ido and Katya straight after this presentation for us in the commentary box. Thank you so much for watching. Catch you next time.
Good night all.
Who always entertained us and tried to show. Yeah, thank you, Rani, our MC here for many, many years. Thank you so much, Rani. And now I need Ido. Ido, please come over here. But we're going to start with Katya. We're doing two microphones at the same time. Let's see how this works out. Katya, congratulations. And how do you feel right now after your shoulder injury, coming back to Studio Bloc Masters and then winning?
Yeah, it's just amazing. I can't believe it. Like, today was like I was in another planet or something, and with such a crowd, it was really, really amazing to climb. Thank you.
It's not your first time here. Was it ever that busy and was it ever that noisy as today?
I don't think so. But like every year, it's like the crowd is amazing. But today, I felt it like differently. I don't know. It was really loud.
And before, just one more question. Which one was your favorite bowler today?
I think the highlight of today's finals was for sure my flash on the slab.
great to hear. We thank you for the flash on the slab. We congratulate you. Have a nice day. A lot of fun with the upcoming World Cup season. Katja, see you again next year. Bye. And we say hello to Ido. Whoa, that was a great performance. How old are you again, Ido?
19
years old from Israel. Is it your first time here at Studio Bloc in Darmstadt, Studio Bloc Masters?
Yes, it's my first time.
Oh, first time coming, winning, easy. What about next year?
I will come, sure.
and win as well?
I hope so.
You got a big crowd with you here, right?
The biggest crowd I ever had.
That's pretty good here. Which one was your favorite memory or your favorite boulder, your favorite move you will take away from today, forever?
I like the second boulder. I really like slab climbing. But the fourth boulder was definitely my favorite. I really love jumping. And so the fourth one.
Did you know you were able to win before you started the fourth boulder?
I know I will be on the podium, but I need to wait for Anze and Jakob to see if I win.
Nice. So what's your plan for this year? World Championship or just Studio Bloc once a year and no other competitions?
I'm planning to do the European Cups and maybe some World Cups.
Cool. Thank you that you joined us here at Studio Bloc, Studio Bloc Masters 2023. Ido! So the crowd behind me, I think that's it for this year. Studio Bloc Masters 2023 here from Studio Bloc in Darmstadt. And do you want to do the okay, bye-bye. Reini has the microphone now. So I'm just saying goodbye and see you again next year here at Studio Bloc Masters 2024 next year. Again, with many beautiful boulders, many beautiful climbing moments and memories you and I will never forget, and an awesome crowd like this. I couldn't ask for anything better. So the World Cup for everyone, Studio Bloc Masters 2023 is over. My name is Nikki. See you next year. Bye.